Hi, welcome to CV Design Studio. Hopefully we'll get to see her at some point. Shagun running around somewhere.
So I wanted to speak to you guys about the foyer. When we had designed it, we went quite creative with it and out of the box. So all these prints that you see, when we designed it, we didn't know how we were going to actually get around to doing it, but fortunately we did, and it looks a replica of the design. So it's one of my happy corners, so I wanted to talk about it. So I have just very small seating on the other side, which again, you can see the floor space through it, so it doesn't bulk up the place. So I wanted to talk about the door as well. I think if you look at the 3Ds, it's kind of replicated again. When we again designed, we put cork board on it, but didn't really know how it was going to come together. So while we were looking around shopping for products, we came through that, and I think it's come out really nice, very beautiful.
Well, I'm here with Ashish and Bhavna and Shagun running around somewhere. Hopefully we'll get to see her at some point. Specifically, we are in the living room right now, which I think is maybe Ashish's favorite.
Yes.
Right? Yeah. So, it was a renovation project initially. I think they were firstly confused whether they wanted to move to another place or they wanted to stay back here, right?
Yes. We were very sentimental of not leaving this place. But then it came at a price of leaving. You know, we couldn't find anything nearby. So, I said, okay, let's just renovate.
And if you look into the before pictures, there was hardly a space for 5 people to sit. When we have our guests coming at our home, we are hardly able to utilize the entire space.
Right.
From the dining room, from the living room.
It so functionally, comes. We've actually got 2 seating areas.
Yes.
And that has still left so much space and a separate dining.
Correct.
Functionally, it's actually a lot of space. So the area between the sofa, we wanted to create something little dramatic, but again, not very loud. There was this pillar, and there was a difference between the pillar and the wall. So there was an automatic niche created, which we wanted to work upon. The glass panel was done around it with gold stickering and a wallpaper. And actually, the clock has been picked up by Ashish and Bhavna, and it's a replica of what's there in the 3D. So we must say that it's been a joint collaboration bringing this together. But all in all, looks perfect and has a classy feel to the wall, however not taking anything away from the decor itself. Yeah, we'll talk about the Shiva thing later, the Shiva section, but
you know, that's just not a picture on the wall that pops out of the wall.
Yes.
Has a very definite character.
As Shivji is supposed to be, I guess.
And this was like the first charm, like it just
I mean, they agreed to do it. First time they got it wrong. Second time they again got it wrong. And it was third time lucky charm. So third time Lord Shiva came in and this is how it looks.
Dining area, we kept it pretty simple. Since it's attached to the wall on one side, we went for a paneling. We've got stone panel with a lacquer glossy shine on top. Taking the wooden panel with groove right up to the ceiling, finishing it off with a circular panel to give it that ending that's required. Again, a tray light all around it. Keeping it very simple, one of Bhavna's friends has framed this painting for us, which again looks perfect with the space. For the dining table, metal work, something different we tried, and this we've not tried before, but it's looking so nice. We are at the kitchen now. It's one of my favorite bits actually in the house. If you look at the tiles, if we start with the tiles, they're very unique, not really matching the color scheme of the kitchen, thus making it, different and vibrant. If you look at the living room flooring, that's wooden flooring, laminated flooring, and that very smoothly comes into the kitchen with these hexagonal tiles, which keep the same color scheme, but are obviously very, very different printed tiles. Uh, Also, if you see, we've got all the accessories here. They're all halfway accessories, giving it that functionality and making it very, very utilitarian. We also have the pull-out baskets, the vegetable trays, which again give it that look, little eclectic look. The chimney, the hob, all state-of-the-art, going very well with the kitchen itself. And if you look at the lift-ups, we've done a small paneling on the sides of the frame, which is again a metallic sheen, bringing in the difference between the white and the blue with that metallic sheen in between. All in all, it looks extremely functional and very pretty. This is their daughter's room. She's a very sweet girl. Her name is Muskan. She is 6 years old. So if you see the interiors, we didn't want to have a lot of designs or colors going on. So we have tried to have two-toned colors, which are white and blue. And we have partitioned it with just a molding, like a linear molding all across. This is the ceiling for the daughter's room. Now, if you look at it, we have used different combinations of triangle designs with wallpapers in the middle. Now, the finish, if you see, is again laminate finish. Now, we didn't want to have a very kiddish look to this ceiling, so we tried out something different, and we hope this turned out good. And yeah, we have used lights in the middle of the triangles, so you know the room is properly lit. On one of the corners of the room, we have placed a very small puja unit. Now, we have given shutters just when it's not in use, they can just close it, with a drawer at the bottom. And beneath the puja, you will see we have placed window seating with ample amount of storage again, and continued with a side table, and beside that is the bed. The wardrobe again is one of the highlights of this room. As you can see, there are two sliding shutters, and on one of them, what we have done is we tried to customize it, and we have used a couple of photos, their family photos, their childhood photos, and we have done a picture gallery, and we have used it in the wardrobe. And on the other side, we have given a long mirror so that she can have a full view and she can get ready. And yeah, so that's about the wardrobe. We are in the master bedroom now. So there is this standard king size bed we have placed. Above the bed, as you can see, we have given, you know, designed some small niches with spotlights inside it, so that, you know, they can just have some kind of display going on. And if you see at the color combination of the room, we have just tried to give something different this time. So we have used a bit of pop of color with purple, and we've used some grays and whites to kind of just merge everything together and bind the whole look of the room. This is the ceiling for the master bedroom. We have given a hexagonal ceiling, and there are strips of grooves we have given all across a hexagon to give it more character, and it is done in pure laminate finish, and you know, it turns out really nicely. This is the niche which was there in the master bedroom, and we thought that it's a perfect area to have a small study nook there. So Ashish sir is a very tech savvy guy, so we thought it would be good to have the top cabinets wherein he can store his books and, you know, other essentials. And coming down, we have a study table with a few drawers, and the space is ample. We have given some lightings to just amp up the place.
the dresser beside the bed. So we have tried to give storage, ample amount of storage here. We have two drawers at the bottom. Then we have a big mirror in which you can have a proper, you know, reflection of when you're getting ready. And to maximize the space also, we have given storage behind the mirror. And there are some storage which is beside the mirror as well. So these are the open shelves that they can use. For the wardrobe, we went for three color scheme, which is white, black and purple color, just again to match the color scheme of the whole room. And these are sliding wardrobes, and for the loft we have given shutters.
Okay, so, but then everything turned out well. Okay.
Yes.
Everything delivered as per our expectations. There were certain areas that we didn't expect it to turn out that well, especially now that I'm comparing the 3Ds of bedroom.
Yes.
And
so I think the 3Ds
living room also. Okay, there's some areas wherein it has come even better than the 3D.
True.
Okay, especially the living room. So yeah, I think both me and Bhavna, we are completely delighted with the way things have turned out. Hats off to you guys.